Hi there. Today I'm going to see if I can figure out if a modern lens is more sharp than a vintage lens. And yeah, let's dive right into it. Here's the lineup. It's actually most of the lenses that I have. Going from left to right is the kit lens that came with my camera. Then it's a vintage lens and FX lens that comes highly recommended from the angry photographer. Then number three, just to the bottom right of the cow, is the classic Nifty 50. Nikon lens. Then it is my favorite vintage lens, the 35-70, the plastic fantastic, the Nikon 35DX, and finally the Sigma 18-35 that comes very highly recommended from Tony Northrop and also gets very high scores on the DxO mark. I have only tested center sharpness of the lens. There's many things that makes up a good lens, and I've listed them here and you can read them yourself. But just be aware that this is just center sharpness and it's only sharpness at f8. So what I did was I took the six lenses and put them to as close to 50 millimeters as I could. And all the lenses had basically the same conditions. So it was 2 meters from the subject on a tripod, remote trigger, artificial light, no variances in the light from the outside. It was shot at night, only f8. Manual focus, meaning all electronics turned off, and so on and so forth. So I think I've done it very consistently throughout the test here, and there were no post-processing and all was shot with RAW. If you're thinking, well, can you get manual exactly the same throughout the test? I think here the depth of field calculation shows that I have plenty of room to sort of hit, even though I miss a little bit, 77 centimeters. That's a lot when you're shooting on 2 meters difference. So I'm not so worried that the manual focus should give variations. Here are the six pictures. As you can see, top left, the DX is very heavy vignetted, and of course in what happened when you put a DX lens on an FX body. You can see a little bit the same here, bottom left, this vignetted, but the Plastic Fantastic actually does a very fine job sitting on a full frame body. And I think actually you can find other videos where this lens actually gets a lot of praise because it's surprisingly sharp and works very well on a full frame body. So that could be a hint for you. If you have a 35DX, you may be able to manage very well with that one, even though you have a full frame body. You can also see that comparing these, that of course this is 35 millimeters, so it cannot really be exactly the same, because you can see the doorknob here is part of the picture, which for the true 50 millimeter distances is not the case. Yeah, so these are the six pictures, and what I've basically done, I've zoomed in on the cow here, as you can see. I had different ways of measuring the sharpness. You can see I had a Manfrotto logo I looked at. I had a picture of the cow, especially the eye was very interesting, and so on and so forth. So I think I've had some pretty good reference point for doing the comparison. So what I did was I compared these one to one and saw which one is the sharpest here. And you can see here, number one is the Nifty 50. Number two is actually my favorite lens, which is also a vintage lens, the 35-70. Number three is the 28-85, and so on and so forth. What surprised me was actually that the Sigma came down so far down the list, and this is actually not consistent also with the DxO mark score. Maybe if you have some experience here why this could be the case, if you think I made a mistake, please leave a comment. I'm happy to see if I can do something to do the retest. But you know, these are my results actually. Then of course you can say, well, you're comparing apples and pears here, because the 50 and the 35, I can't really compare that. Okay, so I thought, let me give it a second try. So I did, I took the two, yeah, if you can call it 50 millimeters, because I took the 35 DX and I took the 50 FX prime lenses and compared them. So to the left here, I have actually printed out one of these test charts. To the left I have the vintage lens, and to the right I have the Plastic Fantastic. And I did it so that I tried to push the 35 millimeter closer to the subject so that it roughly took up the same space in the frame. And you can see I had a little mark here on the wall. I didn't do a terribly good job. And also the pen here to mark where sort of the corners of the frame. And as you can see, I didn't do a terribly good job here, but at least it's more fair comparison. Mind you that when you're showing the next picture, they're flipped. So left is right and right is left. But here you have it, a super, super, super close up. And the blue box here on the top, I'm showing you through a magnifying glass what the original looked like. Meaning this, I think actually it was this section here I zoomed in on. You can see the green zone here. I've marked that on the two pictures and the red zone likewise. And I think the original, you can see a clear texture here. You can also see that on the vintage lens. Whereas I think the Plastic Fantastic is just, you know, a gray surface. The structures are more difficult to see. Also, if you look at the four lines here that are clearly distinct in the original, you can see there's white in between all of these lines. Yeah, I think you can also see that on the FX lens, whereas especially in the top on the DX, that is difficult. So this actually confirms that what I saw in the tests comparing the DX and the FX, you know, maybe on not so even playing ground. If I try to make this very even playing ground, I see the same. It's the vintage lens that wins, maybe not by the biggest margin, but it wins. And this, I would say, is also consistent with my own observations. Here is a leaf from my garden. And here you can see I've taken it and simply cropped it and zoomed in. And you can see the level of detail is amazing. And this is on an FX lens or a body that has 24 megapixels. So it's not even a D810 or a D850. It's just 24 megapixels. And I think it does a fantastic job. Of course, there are many things to a test of a lens. And of course, you also need to look at this, especially color retention and bokeh and flare and all of this. It needs to be part of the equation. But just looking at the sharpness, I will say the Nifty 50 here in the beginning does really, really well. Okay, that's it from me. Thank you for watching. As always, happy shooting. Please like and subscribe if you found this useful. Civilized comments or questions are more than welcome. Happy to see if I can answer. Thank you for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.